Sensei J for the Vidyuu YouTube channel. Today in this video, I'm talking about the new when button is pressed and when button is released scripting code blocks in Horizon Worlds. Before I begin, please do me a favor and like this video, and if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel and ring the bell icon for the latest information regarding Horizon Worlds. Now, on with the video. So we've always had the when button 1 or 2 is pressed and the when button 1 or 2 is released code blocks, but now we have two new code blocks as well. They're called when button is pressed and when button is released, and they exist in conjunction with the previous ones. There's a lot of overlap here, but they provide some nice flexibility as well. All of these code blocks have a pressed version and a released version, which means they fire on either a press of the button or a release of the button. To make this discussion simpler, I'll only talk about the pressed versions here, but know that they're exactly the same with regard to the release versions. First, let's review the original when button 1 or 2 is pressed code blocks. As you may already know, these code blocks fire when an action happens on the X, Y, B, or right thumbstick buttons. The right thumbstick button might actually be the A button instead, because they're interchangeable depending on the player's setup choices. The default gameplay setup is for the A button to cause the player to jump, and therefore the right thumbstick to be the fourth button sampled by these code blocks. I'll talk more about this in a minute, but for now, I'll assume the player is in the default setup. Depending on the hand that's holding the object, the when button 1 is pressed code block samples either the X button or the right thumbstick, and the when button 2 is pressed code block samples either the Y button or the B button. Now, looking at the when button is pressed code block, you can see that you have four choices in the drop-down menu: X, Y, B, and right thumbstick. These are specific to those buttons, and this event won't fire unless that exact button is pressed. Also, the object must be held in the hand that the button occupies. So you can't be holding the object in the right hand and expect a left-hand button to fire. Let's take a look at the player's setup options to see how this code block is affected. If I go to Settings, Gameplay, and I'm in Slide Mode, I will see three options with regard to jump controls. Press A button, press right thumbstick, and right thumbstick up. Like I said before, the default is press A button. But a lot of old school users are still in the press right thumbstick option. To be honest, I don't know anyone who sets this to right thumbstick up, which causes you to jump when you press the right thumbstick forward. Regardless, if a player is either in the press A button or right thumbstick up jump control, then the when button is pressed code block set to right thumbstick fires when the right thumbstick is pressed. However, if the player is in the old school press right thumbstick jump control, then the when button is pressed code block set to right thumbstick fires when the A button is pressed. So the big difference between the when button is pressed and when button 1 or 2 is pressed code blocks boils down to the specifics of the buttons themselves. The former code block will only read buttons on a specific hand, while the latter will read it from either hand. Don't forget that there are also separate code blocks for pressing and releasing the trigger button as well. As a result, you have a total of six buttons to sample. How will you use these code blocks? Let us know in the comments below. Again, don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more content like this. Thanks for watching.